In order to keep your glucose level in the right range, you have to inject insulin in the right amount of insulin. And that amount is very variable between people and for a given person, depending on has this person eaten a lot, not a lot, fat, sports. It varies just all the time. A closed loop is a system that takes that information and based on all the past history of events and glucose is going to automatically update insulin sensitivity and calculate in real time how much insulin does this person need at this very moment. When you develop a product at Diabeloop, the first question is, what are you trying to develop and for whom? Because people living with diabetes has a very wide variety. Once you've selected, okay, you're targeting a product, let's say, for people that do not want or cannot wear a pump. So you're developing a system that's going to adapt for pens. Then you need, first of all, to develop a simulator because you can only develop good machine learning algorithms if you've got solid, reliable, advanced simulators that can simulate the variety of physiologies and types of situations that people have. Once you have that simulator, you develop the algorithms, you iterate, you do virtual clinical trials, thousands of days of clinical trials in virtual. And then you're going to do an actual clinical trial with real people testing the product. Then you need to validate it from a quality and regulatory perspective. Once it's approved, you need to get it reimbursed. And then once it's on the market, you need to train the people, communicate about it, and ultimately launch the product so that it's available to as many people as possible. Diabeloop currently has one product, DBLG1, that is being used successfully by thousands of people in Europe. More than 99% of people keep using it after 6 months. Great feedback from clinical outcomes, usability, people telling us to have more time living rather than managing diabetes. But that's not all. We want to make sure that this product is available to many more people. That means more countries, more insulin pumps, because choice matters for people living with diabetes, more indications. We already have a clinical trial for kids, we have teenagers, we have type 2 diabetes that's being worked on, so it can be available with as many people living with diabetes as possible. Also, there are 40 million people that need insulin in the world. Out of the 40 million, only 2 million have insulin pumps. That means that we're developing a product called DBL for pen that will be able to work with connected pens and not just insulin pumps. And the last thing is continue improving the product itself. When the first smartphones came out, it was great. I remember it was a great impression, but my current smartphone is so much better. Same thing. This is the first version, it works great, but we're going to continue improving it so that it is easier to use, better results overall for the people living with diabetes. So looking ahead, not next year, but 3-5 years from now, a couple of things. First of all is the products from Diabeloop will be available in different platforms, an app on your smartphone, a smartwatch. Now, the advantage of the smartwatch, and Diabeloop has already done clinical trials and is doing work on that, is to have additional sensors that will be able to improve the efficiency of the machine learning and the algorithms to further reduce hypos and improve time in range. So the aim is to have a system, multiple systems, that will be able to have really the burden of living with type 1 needs to be lowered as much as possible. That's the purpose, and with all the software user interface of Diabeloop, we can get there, we'll get there.